There are some myths about the program evaluation. So we shall see what are those myths. And these myths sometimes keep researcher little back or doesn't allow to go into the research full-fledgedly if one has these conceptions in mind. So we shall see what are those. Evaluation is useless activity that generates lots of boring data with useless conclusions. Maybe people have this kind of misconception, especially because the way evaluation studies are conducted and rather further reported. So it is also the responsibility of the researcher to report it in an interesting manner in the context of what are the prevailing conditions or prevailing statistics. So if one gives that context, maybe people would not have this kind of misconception. But evaluation studies, or rather program evaluation studies, are certainly not something, a boring compilation of just an unending data. Evaluation is about proving the success or failure of a program. You take an example of any program, it cannot be 100% success or 100% failure. Every program would have varying ratio of the failure and the success. There would always be some room for improvement for even the most popular program, and even for the program which is supposed to be very, very failure, would have some lessons to learn and would have some positive aspects to it, which the program can use further or which even other programs can use for their implementation. So it is certainly not about finding it black or white, but it is about studying the gray shades of where the program has reached during the implementation and even further follow-up. Evaluation is highly unique and complex process that occurs at a certain time in a certain way and almost always includes the use of outside experts. Having the third party in the evaluation process certainly has its own benefits, but it is not mandatory that the program evaluation has to be carried out by someone who is not the part of the system or someone who is not the part of the team who has conceived the program. Rather, it would be even better if someone from the program development team itself takes up this study and then understands how the success and which are the areas of improvement that are required for that particular program. Because this person would know the background in a deeper manner, he or she would be better able to understand the responses that are gathered and the reactions that one gathers from the field as well as from the students. A person needs to completely understand the terms such as validity and reliability. Now, since this is a concept related to research, we call program evaluation is a research. So people generally have this notion that it has to deal with something like validity and reliability, but that is not so. One can take up the evaluation studies and the program evaluation studies at varying depths and maybe at times to get just the superficial view of what has been the best practices or the success, and at times it could be going in a very, very detailed manner. So if one removes all these myths or misconceptions from one's mind, it will be easier and more fruitful for conducting the program evaluation studies. Now, which are those areas where the program evaluation is most appropriate? Now, especially for the researchers who are newly entering into the area of research, they find it very difficult, like whether this program can be reviewed, whether it can be evaluated. And maybe the discussion further would be helpful for those researchers. When one wants to understand or verify and even further improve the impact of the services or products offered to the client, maybe kind of program evaluation would be a better option, and that gives a lot of outputs which could be further useful for improvement of the services or products. Program evaluation is also used from the implementation point of view. At times it is conceived in the best possible manner, but if there are any flaws in actual implementation or in the delivery of the program, then it certainly program evaluation gives those inputs. So for improving the better implementation or better delivery, the program evaluation studies are very much useful. At times it happens that the persons who are actually delivering the program, they feel that they are doing what they have planned to do earlier. So how far they are in consensus with this reality, how far they are close to this reality can be studied through program evaluation. When one wants to make the wild comparisons between the parallel programs, even that is a situation where program evaluation would be useful. Many a times what happens is the parallel programs are offered by many institutions simultaneously, and then it becomes necessary for an organization to study the program or one's own efforts in order to check whether one is lagging behind as compared to the other efforts. At times what happens is one needs to talk publicly or share publicly the efforts made through the program. For making these claims authentic, one needs to have the sound research base, sound database for making such claims. This database can be generated only through the efforts like program evaluation. When one takes up the program evaluation, one needs to have some key considerations while taking up this study. One has to take certain decisions while conducting this program evaluation. Rather, the decisions are taken up before the actual conduction of the program evaluation. We shall see what are those considerations. For what purposes is the evaluation being done? So this is something very much similar to the objectives of the research study. So maybe a program could be same, but two different researchers may have the program evaluation from different angles, from different objectives. So it is essential that the objectives are decided right in the beginning. Who are the audiences for the information from the evaluation? Is the evaluation study being conducted for his or her own knowledge pursuit? Or is it for giving some public image? Is it for the people who are designing and developing the program? Is it for the people who are actually implementing? So the results that are going to come at the end of this study, for whom the results will be most useful, that will be the audience of this particular research. What kinds of information are needed to make the decision you need to make and or enlighten your intended audiences? So whether we need the information about, say, the skills that are being developed, or whether it is about the knowledge base that is being developed, whether it is about the market value in terms of the takers for the students, and so on. So depending on the focus, which area needs to be tapped, even it is a program evaluation, exactly what needs to be focused, that has to be decided in the beginning. Now once the objectives are decided and the audience is decided, that gives a lot of inputs and lot of direction, lot of clues in terms of what information needs to be gathered for conducting the program evaluation. From what sources should the information be collected? Now here the word sources is very much similar to something called as population in research proposal. So just like in a research, we decide that the data which I need, who is the best possible resource to provide me that data? It's the same, exactly same focus over here, that who is that best resource for giving me the data that I'm looking for this particular program evaluation. How can that information be collected in a reasonable fashion? So this is now indicating towards the instruments and techniques for data collection. So how do I collect this data? How easy it is, or whether I'm asking for something confidential, whether it is feasible to collect the data, and so on. All these considerations would come while addressing this kind of a question. When is the information needed? So by when must it be collected? So what is the timeline of completing this particular research, and also the timeline for the data analysis and when do the results are needed? For example, if there is some document to be created within, say, a span of 15 days, then it will not be possible to get into a really detailed study. Then one would have to go something for superficial study. So just get a rough idea about the best practices and the areas where the improvement is needed. In that case, the study will be very small. But if one has a longer time dimension or longer time duration in hand, then one can go for detailed study. What resources are available to collect the information? Now, here the word resources means the resources that are available with the researcher in terms of the skill, manpower, and even the financial resources, time resources, intellectual resources, and so on. So, whether the researcher has these resources and to what extent, these are some of the considerations by the researcher. So, you can say, note from these points that all these pointers are nothing but something very much similar to what thinking goes behind writing the research proposal, right from objectives and then what is the population, what is the data to be collected from that population, which are the instruments for data collection and so on. So, the procedure is exactly same, the considerations are exactly same. The only value addition over here is the way they are put here is in the context of the program evaluation. So, the pointers were very much focused to the concept of program evaluation. Now, there are three types of program evaluation depending on the focus. So, we shall see them one by one. The first one is the goal-based program evaluation. As the name suggests, the focus here is to what extent the goals of the program have been achieved and which are the areas where the improvement is needed. So, the questions that are addressed in this kind of a study are, how were the program goals established? Was the process effective? What is the status of the program's progress towards achieving the goals? Will the goals be achieved according to the timeline specified in the program implementation or operations plan? If not, then why? Such and similar questions are addressed while taking up this kind of a study, that this was the initial objective, to what extent it is being achieved, and whether it will be completed during the timeline. Now, from these questions, you can also note one more point here is, it is not necessarily that this kind of a study has to be conducted after the completion of the program. But the kind of questions that are raised here are, which could be answered even during the program. Rather, it would be helpful if such kind of a study is conducted during the program being offered. We shall see the next time. The second type of study is the process-based program evaluation. Now, in the first type, it was goal. So, it was only focused on the output. Here, the process is important. So, how the program is being offered and what are the learning experiences that are given to the students during the program or as a part of the coursework, all these aspects are in focus while conducting this kind of research. So, what are the questions that are addressed when this kind of a study is taken up? On what basis do employees or the customers decide the products or services are needed? Here, the products may be students if it is conducted in the context of education. What is required of employees in order to deliver the product or services? How are employees trained about how to deliver the products or services? So, here as you see, the questions are addressed to how. So, naturally the process comes into picture, and whether that how they are trained, and if they are trained in a particular manner, then the employer is able to decide whether this particular student or this particular person that is the output of this training program will be useful for the purpose for which he or she is being appointed. We shall see the third and the last type of program evaluation, that is the outcome-based program evaluation. So, you can see the very beautiful sequence. Initially, it was with what objectives the program is taken up. then what was the process that was taken up, or what was the process of conduction of the program, and now we have come to the third stage, that is the outcome of the program. So here the outcome of the program is studied from the point of view of the utility. So this is once again, may it be a product or may it be the actual human beings that are the result of the program. This kind of study helps in addressing the questions like whether the program that is offered, whether it is really doing any value addition to the people who are being sent to the world of work. And then it again gives the input for the goals of the program and the way the program is being conducted and designed, also deployed. The outcomes in this case are generally considered in terms of enhanced skill or enhanced conceptual clarity and so on. In this era of especially the skill development, the skills are much more in focus, even if they are the intellectual skills or even if they are the psychomotor skills. So thus we saw the three types of program evaluation studies, and depending on the focus and the purpose, one would take up the type of program evaluation study that is most suitable for the purpose.